Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 9.1, Problem 3. This is Section 9.1, Problem number 3. It says, find a 90% confidence interval for a random sample with a mean of 688 and a sample size of 36. Assume that the population standard deviation is known to be 90. So if we have to find the confidence interval, you're going to use the confidence interval formula, which is x bar plus or minus sigma, the standard deviation, over square root of n, the sample size, times z sub c, your confidence coefficient. So to fill that in, the x bar is the sample mean, which is given as 688. Plus or minus sigma, the standard deviation, and at the end it says the population standard deviation is known to be 90, over square root of n, n is the size of the sample, so this is a sample of size 36, so that's n, times z sub c, the confidence coefficient. So what you have to do is look up the confidence coefficient for a confidence of 90%. And there's a little chart where you can look that up. And the confidence coefficient for 90% is 1.645. So that's how the formula fills in. If you fill it in correctly and you take your time, most likely you'll get the right answer. But this is a very important step to fill it in correctly. X bar is 688, standard deviation is 90, sample size is 36, confidence coefficient is 1.645. Once you have it filled in, the first thing that you must deal with is the square root. That has to be dealt with before anything else. So I'll leave the 688 for a minute, plus or minus, the 90 in the numerator can stay. Square root of 36 is 6, because 6 times 6 is 36. And I will leave the 1.645 for a minute. Now the next thing we can do is reduce the 90 divided by 6. It does happen to go in evenly. If you don't see what it is off to the side somewhere, you can use your calculator. 90 divided by 6 equals, and the calculator will tell you pretty quickly that it's 15. So 90 divided by 6 is 15. So I can go 688 plus or minus 15 times 1.645. Now, at this point, the next thing that you would do is 15 times 1.645. That's also something you'd probably want to do with the calculator. So off to the side, you go 15 times 1.645. And the calculator will tell you that it is 24.675. That's the result you get. So I can do that multiplication now, and I have 688 plus or minus 24.675. So now that I'm down to a single value after the plus and minus, I can now split this into a separate minus and a separate plus. I tend to like to put the low end of the interval first. It can really be expressed in either order, but what we have is 688 minus 24.675 to the upper end of your interval is the same numbers but with a plus, 688 plus 24.675. So for the low end, when we subtract, 688 minus 24.675 will be 663.325. And the upper end of the interval, when we add 688 plus 24.675, will be 712.675. So we know that if we did examine the entire population and found the true mean of the entire population, the population mean, it's very likely that it would be between 663.325 and 712.675. And that information is based only on a single sample of 36 items, which is a pretty powerful type of math.